Hi, Dave Deck here, Superintendent of Fauquier County Public Schools, with another edition of Checking In. Two things of interest this week. One is a question, one is just some information that's necessary to share because of some questions that we've received. One has to do with the SAT prep classes that we, to this point, had offered at our high schools. The question from a parent was, why aren't all the high schools offering the SAT prep classes through Kaplan? Because we were heretofore able to offer it for substantially less than if you were taking the course independently through Kaplan. So the answer is we are that Kettle Run and Fauquier are offering the boot camp. It's kind of a two-day boot camp in preparation for the SAT test. That's being offered at those two schools. We are researching. The honest answer is I don't know exactly why those courses are in the program of studies. I'm not exactly sure why, what's going on with the registration for those classes, but we're going to find out. Mr. Warner's doing some research to determine exactly what's going on with the Kaplan course and what the possibilities or potentials for offering the Kaplan courses at the high schools, or at least at one high school where all three high schools can participate. So stay tuned for that. I think the cost of that was about $300 to take the course. And I believe it was offered on Wednesdays after school and on Saturdays. So I believe that's the schedule. So stay tuned. And as we get more information, we'll share it out. Our SAT scores, again, went up from the class of 2017, went up significantly again. I don't have that data sitting in front of me, but it was quite a jump. Like it was at least 100 points over the state average. So I don't know if that's because of the class or not, or the boot camps or not. We don't have any idea to measure that really. But we're going to find out and figure out what's going on. I know in some instances, if classes are offered and they don't get the enrollment they need, then they don't offer them. However, with SAT prep, those classes always fill up quickly. So we'll figure out what's going on there. The other question slash concern has to do with a march by peaceful protesters who are going north from Charlottesville up to Washington, D.C., and they're scheduled to be marching through Remington Friday. And so a couple things. One, what was advertised is about a 10,000-person peaceful march against white nationalism, nationalists or whatever. As of yesterday, it was about 30 people. So we're not, and neither of the state's state troopers, state police department, they're not anticipating anything like that or anything nearly that large. And thus far, the march has been very peaceful. It's been up the 29 corridor. The local sheriff's office we met with this morning, they don't anticipate that they're going to even go into the town of Remington. It's more likely that they'll stop on 29 at the park and ride there just over the county line. And at that point there, those marchers are picked up and they're taken back to wherever they're staying on the bus. They don't spend the night in Remington. So we don't anticipate any problems. The state police are on it. We feel very reassured by them and by what we heard from the county sheriff's office this morning. So they don't have any concerns. We don't have any concerns. There's a large state police presence with that group as they made their way up 29. And as I've mentioned, there hasn't been any problems. It's been very peaceful. And we don't anticipate that they're even going to go into the town of Remington. And by the way, they're marching around 10 or 11 miles a day at about a mile an hour. So we don't even anticipate them being in Fauquier County in and around Remington until about 8 or 9 o'clock at night. So that wouldn't impact Pierce Elementary School in any way, shape, or form, or any of our other schools. So that's that. If you have any additional questions or concern, please feel free to share. Thank you.